de la ville
qui nous éteint un par un.
Elle nous éteint un par un. Ces avenues couvertes de pétales de mon cœur jadis se sont transformées en pieux.
Et je prie
pour un rayon de soleil pour réchauffer mon âme.
When I came in, as I walked out, that looks like a synapse.
I'm not joking.
And I thought, yeah, okay, done.
I have a friend, right, who works, he's a researcher in medical science just up the road here, and I've met through working here doing the building work, and he supplies me with all medical textbooks, with all the images, and he works with muscular dystrophy, and I'm told he's the world leader.
Yeah.
Robert Capsa. He was on the front page of The Age about a year or two ago, because they reckon they're making some breakthroughs into that particular area, and that's his specialisation. But I made this actually, I made two of them. This one, I made one for him, because he gave me the images, so this is the other one. They're identical, and they're just basic. Well, okay, what can we do? I'll go back to the single building block, and it seemed that the most basic thing I could find was one neuron. And then he really reacted to it, because he went, that's great, that's the fundamental building block of my what I do.
Yeah.
And research, it's just, how did you figure out that it was this? Like, I don't know, it's just an intuition. So it's probably equally appropriate.
Yeah, well, that...
And my cousin was also down here.
Of 11 years practice for Michael, prints, mono prints spanning 11 years. Mono prints are one-off prints, so they're very much akin to a painting. There is no way to reproduce them again. And because of the way he treats his plates, he inks his plates and impresses his plates, and the image is transferred onto the canvas or the rag paper, and then it's very much like a painting, especially because he starts with inks and then removes the inks. So probably the closest I can think of is printing processes that involve the starting with blacks and taking away the blacks until you end up with white. So it's the opposite of starting with white and adding blacks. It's a very interesting process that. When I look at Michael's work, I think about how he's created the image by what he has erased rather than what he's put there. So it's an interesting thing that the image comes about from ink being taken away rather than being applied.
work sitting at home in drawers that's never been shown. So it seemed a really good idea to put it all together.
I've probably produced over the last 12 years anywhere from, you know, 600 to 1,000 prints. It was a lot of sifting. It wasn't hard to make choices because I think work spoke for itself. It was self-evident that some things were a lot better than other things, so it was pretty easy to exclude a lot of things and to get left with a reasonable group of work. I've had printing exhibitions before. This is the first one of purely mono prints, and it was just to follow the evolution of that technique as I practice it over about 12 or 13 years. And that's the main deciding factor. So it's to explore a range of different subjects and a range of images, you know, covering everything from landscape, medical imagery, genetic imagery, people, places, flowers, botanical stuff too, like quite a broad range of images and focuses, but looked at, you know, developing and extending the same technique and how it's evolved over 12 years from a single one colour to up to six colours and got much more complex and much more involved as I've taught myself more about it and explored and learned, I guess.